Yeah, you guys can, you're ready to go.
Thank you. Have we got one? Yes, we are live. Well, thank you very much. Thank you for coming out. How nice to have people listening and applauding. And not throwing anything. Yeah. Yeah, my criteria, as I've said this before to folks, my criteria for a good gig after 50 years of playing are two. It's two simple criteria. You get your money and no one throws anything. That's a good gig. Everything above and beyond that is the frosting, and you folks have provided some nice frosting on this, so thank you very much indeed. The band is Evening Sky. Gino Rosati at the guitar. Eric Hastings at the drums. The one and only Chris Brooks at the Potenza steel guitar. I'm Joe Potenza, I'll be your bass player for the evening. And we're really happy to have our guest recording artist with us that's going to join us later in the set, our little sister, Eden Casteel. And perhaps the fanciest tip jar on the face of the earth, right here. We're not worthy. Those two tunes were written by Gino Rosati. That last tune was called Slip and Slide. And that's on the recording One Mic, Two Weekends. The tune before that was called Van Cleef, also written by Gino Rosati. Destined for a spaghetti western somewhere in the line. And available as well on the Desert at Night recording. Where's the birch table? Oh, all right, right out the hall. Yep. Professional musicians. Well, yeah, they'll be here later. Okay, this is something that I'm responsible for. This is called Where the Buses Don't Run. Thank you.
And now, please welcome to the stage the one and only Eden Casteel.
See, this is my evening sky dress. I'm like, yes, thank you. I want you all who are filming to make sure that you get on social media and say you're here at the Blue Room watching Evening Sky, because I think those two things kind of go together.
Okay.
All right,
it's pretty great.
So glad this place is here. I'm doing a little bit of an open mic on Sunday nights as well, so hope you'll come to that. Let me play for you. But right now we get to do tunes that are off of our upcoming album. So this first one is Sea of Heartbreak.
Thank you.
nice guy. I told you, it's all social media. It's great. So, yeah, we've been making tracks for this album, what, 18 months?
Yeah.
It's been an extended process.
On and off.
Yeah, between, you know, famine, allergies, whatever. But it's all been good. Meteor strikes. Yeah, lots of things have colluded to make this not happen, but yet we're here at this point, and I'm thrilled. So it's been wonderful to play with these guys, and they have such a great sense of humor, right? Yes. I mean, I think that's their secret sauce, really. So, yeah, they put up with me. I really appreciate it. All right, this next one is by Jimmy Webb. And, yeah, we all love Mr. Webb, and he had a birthday, you said, right?
Yep.
Recently?
Yep.
And he got this song title from a sci-fi novel in 1968. So the sci-fi novel was called The Moon is a Harsh Mistress. And he just saw the paperback cover and thought that was a great title for a song. And so the song has nothing to do with the sci-fi, but you can go ahead and imagine that if you want. Right? It probably be some, you know, apocalyptic thing starring Brad Pitt. But I'm going to do The Moon is a Harsh Mistress.
And look, it fades away.
Robert Plant had a solo album called The Principle of Moments, right? MTV Generation? Okay. Had a really good video for a song called Big Log. Anybody remember Big Log? Good, not that many, so you're going to love our version. That's great.
This is the definitive
version. Yeah, this is the definitive version. Much better than Robert Plant's from 1983. I mean, God. No, but we love that song, and so we created our own version. His is wonderfully atmospheric, and so is Evening Skies. Would the force ever be with you? Okay. Is that, that's the first time we ever played that live. And what am I supposed to say? That it's Eric's
arrangement.
And it's Eric's arrangement of this tune.
Yeah.
Yes,
absolutely.
Yes, made me happy. See a little bit.
Eden Casteel, everybody. Eden will be back next set to join us for some more tunes from the album. This is something that was, again, written by Gino Rosati. This is our homage to our spiritual father, Bill Frisell. It's called Bill's Porch.
Thank you.
It's kind of fitting that we did that trippy kind of tune on the weekend that Woodstock happened. So everybody's safe. You have the safe tent is back that way. We all know now by now not to take the brown ass.
Don't take the brown ass.
Especially when we're playing that tune. We got a couple more. Gonna do. This is again written by Gino. We did this on an EP called The Long Weekend. We recorded it with two great horn players. And we're going to do a quartet version of it. This is called The Fame Street Crawl.
Thank you.
Tito Rosati, everybody! Eric Hastings! Chris Brooks!
Yay!
Bring back Eden Casteel to sing it along. How about it?
So the dirty secret for me is that, yeah, it took 18 months to make our album, but it's because I kept on asking for like just 10 more takes. But it's because it was so much fun to work with these guys, because this is what they do, right? So whether it's a ballad or anything else, this is how much fun we have. So I just didn't want it to end. And I'm really glad that it doesn't have to end. Right? So, but they've also recorded with a lot of different people. So it's E.B. Scott Plus is that whole series, and the CDs are available out there if you want to see them. Leland Brown and Tish Adams, Michelle Michael Hill, Ben Shaw. Who have I forgotten? We got about 10 more. Yeah. So, Leland Brown, absolutely. So I just want to have a long list of people they recorded with, and it's nothing but fun.
Thank you, bro.
So this is a wonderful Gordon Lightfoot tune. If I could breathe. up for something completely different. And that is what Evening Sky is great at. Right? Completely different. That's what they're great at. Right? And that might also be my outfit and act too. Completely different. You can hope. So, this is from a musical called Hadestown, currently on Broadway. Anybody seen Hadestown?
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Well, you're ahead of me. I just listened to it a whole lot. And this is the character of Persephone, a lady of the underground.
Can you play a little bit else? You want me to? Yeah, you do the thing.
Okay. I don't know who's the lady.
Thank you.
now. We'll take a break.
And now they will take a short intermission. Keep telling everybody on socials about Blue Room and Evening Sky. Thank you so much.
Oh God, he's at the mic again. Oh my God. I'm just expressing Gino's unspoken. Band's been together 5 years, I know. Don't give him a mic. We do get requests. This one we know, so we'll do it. It wasn't in the set list, but it was requested, and it's a beautiful song. And it was Jimmy Webb's birthday. So.
Thank you. Thank you.
Moving in an entirely different direction altogether, please welcome back Eden Casteel.
I've got like four dresses back there. So I just felt like giving you a little shove. So, this is Michael LeGrand and an Alan and Marilyn Bergman tune, recorded by Tony Bennett and Bill Evans, famously. Also Barbara, and lots of people, and us. It's called You Must Believe in Spring.
You must believe in
right, so, Major Linda Ronstadt fan, me. And so we're going to do one of her best known ones. Even though it's a red dress, think blue.
Thank you.
a nasty old blues that Dino wrote called Dry Spell.
Dry Spell.
We go right in.
Yeah, right in.
Thank you.
Glasses of wine, so I don't know even what to base. And I don't do mic stands very well. As you can tell, I'm not from around here. I'm from southern Rhode Island. Prizes.
Crazy.
And how about this band?
Yeah!
And then, to Footstomp, the wonderful, the beautiful, the talented Eden Casteel. I just got a super fan badge. Let me tell you a little story. First of all, she's taller than me. This mic stand is like way up here for me. Anyway, I went down this rabbit hole because she knows somebody that I know. And I was like, oh my gosh. And then I found one of her posts. And I just liked it. And now Facebook is like every day, hey, you've got a super fan badge. You're an Eden fan, super fan. Eden super fan. Eden super fan. Anyway, go on the social medias, the YouTubes and all that good jazz. And look at her stuff. Check out this band online because they're incredible. I'm a little biased because I know these cats really well, and I love them both. So you're very fortunate to be in their company. They're exceptional. And thank you to the Blue Room for supporting live music.
Thank you, love.
We're going to continue with something else that was written by Gino Rosati. This is one that has a line in at the end. Well, I shouldn't make excuses, but the line at the end of this tune, I get this right maybe 50% of the time. So,
yeah, the other
time
I get it right
30%. Yeah, well, between us, that's a solid 80%. Those of you who know me know that my business card says most of the roots, most of the times. Simple goal. This is called Bowlagumbo. It features Eric Hastings.
It does.
Yes, it does. Remember? Remember that? We are doing the same tune, right? Yeah. Okay. have some repairs to do. Okay. Eden, you want to go up and tell the story?
Yeah, sure.
A little history of the recording.
I'm hiding the drum repairs and about telling you a story. Alright, so here's the last, like, the song I'm going to do now, I did yesterday in a recording studio in Chicago. So, yesterday morning at 4 a.m., I went up to TF Green, I flew to O'Hare, I sat in O'Hare for about 3 or 4 hours, and then I got driven to a studio where I got to play this song. I only got to do 1 minute of it, though. And so, I gotta finish it tonight, gotta do it. So after I played 1 minute of this song, a Sheryl Crow song, then I played two others, and that was it. And then I took an Uber back to the airport, and I flew from O'Hare back to Rhode Island. That was all yesterday. I got home at about 11 o'clock, and crashed. And then this morning, I had a rehearsal at my house with Joe and Eric. So I'm a voice coach, that's my muggle job. And I have a client who's doing her one-person show at the end of September. So today we had our first rehearsal with the band. So all I want to do is play with these guys. And all I want to do is the name of the next song we're going to do when the drums are fixed. I tied it all in. So, but we are not going to do like a Gregorian chant version of it. It does need drums. So, I mean, I don't know about you. I don't want to hear the Gregorian chant version of it. Do you? Right, shortest of all.
All I want to do is purge my guilt.
Yeah, Joe says all he wants to do is purge his guilt.
That's the Gregorian
chant. Right, that's the Gregorian chant. Right. So yeah, I got to do this one. I got to do just like a little of the greatest hits. Now I get to do it all. Ain't no disco. It ain't no country club either. This is the Blue Road.
Bye.
more from me, and then there's more from Evening Sky. This is by Dan Hicks, of late renown and fame. Such a hilarious, wonderfully talented person and musician. And he recorded this with Maria Miguel, also a wonderfully talented musician. Some folks say it's cool to have some fun in life. You walk on Raymond Street, cause you just found another. Every single one they see on the street. He cuts his heel a bit, cause he got some kind of beat. He cuts his knees a bit, he's in the perfect day. He rocks around, and nobody looks around. Somebody wants a ball to throw.
Thank you.
In answer to someone's question, yes, we do color-coordinate our guitars. A lot of thought and planning and phone calls and texts go into this. So, yeah, so I'm crazy. We want to harness this, and we'd like to know that. There's a jumping little number written by Gino called Goodbye Columbus. Actually, I can tell this now, right? Yeah. It's a kiss off to a former employer. And well deserved. We got time for one more song. We're gonna do we're gonna bring Martin Schwacha to play. Once again, people, even the people who are talking. Yeah, that's right, I'm talking to you. Gino Rosati at the guitar!
He says he doesn't need it.
I'm Italian, I don't need it. Eric Hastings at the drum! Was every day in my house growing up. Chris Brooks and the pedal steel guitar. How about our guest, Martin Schwacha? Audra and the one and only Eden Casteel. It's in the C, right? Yeah, why not in the D and C after? Second line.
Thank you.